Angular Native 2 adds a streaming extension to the Resource API. The new extension uses a streaming loader instead of the basic loader. The streaming loader is designed for continuous, dynamic updates. The basic loader is designed for one-time requests. For example, the streaming loader can use WebSocket to maintain a persistent connection. The streaming loader function must be contained in the stream option. This function must return a promise. WebSocket receives messages in a stream, one by one. The message event is triggered whenever WebSocket receives a new message. The onMessage property of the WebSocket object stores the handler function for this event. This function executes whenever a message is received. Each message is just a JSON string. This promise must be resolved when the first message is received. Its result value must be only a signal. The value of this signal must follow a specific structure, an object with a value property. The value property must store a resource value. We must follow the structure exactly. In this example, the resource value is an array of message strings. Each message is a single string. Specify this type to ensure proper type safety. The final step is to update this signal whenever a new message is received. The signal has a built-in update method to modify its value based on the current value. This return value must also follow the required structure. This new array is stored in the value property inside an object. Now, let's open the component template and display the messages list. We can get the value of the stream resource using the value property. Since this property is a signal, we must add parentheses after its name. This works the same as for non-stream resource. Let's see a real demo of this code. The remote server sends a message every second. Let's see what happens if an error occurs in one of the messages. This is the WebSocket server code for this example. It sends a message every second. This is just one JavaScript file. Don't forget to install the WebSocket module. So, here's the plan in short. Create a stream resource, create a promise, connect to the server, resolve the promise with signal when the first message is received. Continue to update the signal whenever a new message is received. This video is pre-release first loop. All updates will be in the pinned comment.